Welcome to Shree Learning Academy. Our today's topic is Understanding Application Whitelisting. So let's get started. Application whitelisting is a key strategy in cybersecurity that is centered around the idea of deny by default. In essence, this means that unless a software application is specifically authorized or whitelisted, it will not be allowed to execute on a computer system. The fundamental principle behind application whitelisting is prevention. By permitting only known trusted software to operate, the potential attack surface for malware is significantly reduced. The concept of whitelisting versus blacklisting. To better understand the concept of whitelisting, it's helpful to compare it to its opposite, that is blacklisting. In a blacklisting model, all applications are allowed to run by default, except those that are explicitly identified as malicious and added to a blacklist. This is similar to a security approach at an event where everyone can enter except those on a specific no-entry list. The issue with this approach is that new unrecognized threats can slip through the net. Conversely, whitelisting is more like an exclusive party where the only people allowed in are those specifically named on a guest list. The advantage here is that even if a piece of software is a brand new threat that has never been seen before, it will not be able to execute unless it's been specifically whitelisted. The power of whitelisting in combating malware. Whitelisting provides an incredibly robust level of protection against malware. This is because instead of trying to identify and block harmful software, a virtually impossible task given the vast and continually evolving landscape of malware, whitelisting solutions simply deny everything by default, allowing only those software applications they know to be safe. For instance, consider a scenario where you have received an email with an attached file that is unbeknownst to you, laced with a new strain of malware. And if you try to open the file, your antivirus might not recognize the threat because it's never seen this particular malware before. But if you have whitelisting solution in place, it doesn't matter if the malware is a new strain or not. Unless the file is an approved, whitelisted application, it won't be allowed to execute. The challenges with application whitelisting. While application whitelisting offers a robust line of defense against malicious software, it isn't without its challenges. The most obvious is the task of managing the whitelist itself. Every new software that needs to be installed has to be thoroughly vetted and then added to the whitelist, a process that can be time-consuming. Additionally, whitelisting solutions are not foolproof and have vulnerabilities that can be exploited by savvy attackers. There can also be configuration issues that may allow unauthorized software to slip through or cause legitimate software to be blocked. This highlights the importance of keeping the whitelisting software and its configuration up to date and monitored for any potential anomalies. Interpreting whitelisting reports and logs. The output reports and logs generated by a whitelisting solution provide valuable insights into the attempts made to launch unapproved software. This can be an early warning sign of a malware infection or an indication that users are trying to install unapproved software, which might be either legitimate, work-related software, or potentially risky applications. For example, a report might show multiple failed attempts to launch a certain application. This could be a sign that a user is attempting to install a non-whitelisted software for work purposes. Alternatively, it could be an indication that a piece of malware is trying to execute. Careful analysis of these reports help IT administrators in two ways. It can prompt an investigation into potential security breaches and guide the decision to approve additional software applications. Analyzing and making decisions. By analyzing these logs, organizations can identify patterns and trends. This analysis can lead to decision-making about which additional applications to whitelist. Perhaps an unrecognized but safe and beneficial application is being regularly blocked. After proper vetting, the software could be added to the whitelist. At the same time, the analysis could reveal that a whitelisted application is posing more risk than initially considered, causing reconsideration of its approval. For instance, if a whitelisted application is regularly being exploited as a pathway for security breaches, it might be safer to revoke its whitelisted status. In summary, application whitelisting offers a powerful way to keep computer systems secure by allowing only pre-approved software to run. While it provides robust protection against malware, there are challenges to overcome, such as managing the whitelist and handling vulnerabilities in the whitelisting software itself. The logs and reports generated by these solutions are invaluable tools, offering insights into attempts to launch unapproved software. By carefully analyzing this data, organizations can make informed decisions about which applications to add or remove from the whitelist, thereby maintaining a balanced and effective security posture. Thank you so much for watching this video. Do check out the written explanation on our website. And don't forget to take this quiz based on this video. The links are in the description box below. Subscribe to our channel to watch more interesting videos. And if you have any doubts, do let us know in the comment section and we will try our best to solve them for you. For private coaching, do contact us by visiting shreelearningacademy.com or on WhatsApp. See you in the next one.